If you're using Messaging Center in .NET Maui, then stop what you're doing and pay attention. Messaging Center is really going away in .NET 10, and in this video, I'm going to save your behind by showing you how to implement a better performing alternative in minutes. Maybe you've already watched my video on what is coming for .NET Maui in .NET 10. I highly recommend that you do because there is amazing stuff in there. Also some obsoletions and deprecations and removal of things like the messaging center that we're going to talk about in this video. So make sure to check out that video. The link will be down below in the video description, or I'll link it towards the end of this video as well. So why not just stick around until the end and catch both of these videos? That would be amazing. Okay, so messaging center. If you don't know what messaging center is, it's a publish subscriber pattern supporting mechanism, basically. And I haven't confirmed this with the team, but I feel the history here, it has been around since Xamarin Forms, and I feel the history here is that we needed this mechanism for ourselves. We needed a pub/sub, for short, way to kind of like send a signal to the platform layer for some things from the abstract layer. In our code base, it was still used for like, hey, showing an alert, right? So if you do display alert, we are sending a signal through the messaging center so that we don't have the coupling between like, hey, whenever we use to send an alert and the page that you actually want to show it on, right? So personally, I'm not a fan of this pattern. It's like a last resort if you really don't know what else to do, how to like reach the code that you really want to be at, then use pub/sub because it's like very loosely coupled, easy to break. I don't really like it personally. But what we did is we made it public. So also you could use it, right? And you definitely did because we deprecated Messaging Center for a little while now, I think already in like .NET 7 or .NET 8. We actually removed it at some point, but then you came with like a lot of feedback. There was a lot of people who said like, I'm using this throughout my application and I'm not ready to migrate all of this out, right? So what we did, this was still in the preview phase, right? That's why we do the preview phases, to get the early feedback, and we put it back, right? We were like, okay, this was too early for you. We hear you. Let's put it back and do it a little bit longer. But it's been deprecated now for multiple years. You should be in a good spot to migrate your Xamarin app. Applications. So we're really removing Messaging Center this time, and we're not putting it back. Okay. So what I did, I vibe coded, I talked to Copilot, and we sat down and we created a drop-in compatible plugin for Messaging Center. So what that means is like, this plugin has the exact same methods in there, the exact same method signatures. So you can just drop it in, just install the application, the plugin, and then it will just work, right? You don't need to change any code, or a little bit, and it will just work as it did before. So that is there, but I changed the implementation because the messaging center, if you look at like benchmarks, is horrible, right? It's never been optimized for performance. It never really was meant for you to be used, but it was public, so you started using it. So what I did is, under the hood, I used the Mvvm toolkit Weak Reference Manager, which is way optimized, right? Like, that one is off the charts, beats all the other pub/sub mechanisms out there. You should definitely be using that. And ideally, just transition to that directly, right? Because the only thing that I've created is a little thin wrapper around it so that you have the least amount of work to just drop in that plugin and work with it. So you don't need to worry about the transition and the migration right now. But ideally, you want to use the Weak Reference Manager because that has a ton of extra functionality that will make it easier for you, right? So that should be your end goal. But if you're like, I've got enough on my plate, I understand, I get that, you can use this plugin as kind of like a transition tool, if you will. Let's hop over to my screen and see what this is actually all about. So here I have a little sample application. I just did a file new .NET Maui project, and I replaced some things already so you don't have to watch me struggle with that. I removed the .NET bot, the labels, all that kind of stuff, and I added three buttons. One with subscribe, right? Because pub/sub, how it works, you have to subscribe, you have to unsubscribe, and then you can send messages, right, to do things, to trigger logic. So here we have the subscribe button, which subscribes to the messaging center. We send a message that then will show a little alert on screen, and then we unsubscribe, right? So we have these three things. So functionally here, subscribe, right, nothing happens. I didn't really any feedback there that lets you know that you're actually subscribed. Send message, we should see a little alert here, okay. And then unsubscribe, we're unsubscribed, and whenever I send a message, nothing happens, right? Because I'm not subscribed here. You can have multiple subscribers if you want to trigger some other logic here, but this is just one example, one page that shows a little alert. One important change that we'll get to in a minute is, if you subscribe twice, for the messaging center that is in .NET MAUI right now, you're allowed to do that, right? We don't check that. So if you do send message now, you will get it twice, right? Because we're subscribed twice, so we get it delivered twice. Not great, but it was allowed right now. For my plugin, because Week Reference Manager does not support this, if you subscribe twice, it will break. So that's a breaking change in comparison to the messaging center right now. Be aware of that. If you're going to do that, if you're doing that right now in your code, find a way around that, right? Because that's not going to be supported. It will throw an exception. Okay, so we got this. Let's look at, let me stop running this for a little bit. Let's look at the code, not super complicated. You can already see messaging center deprecated, right? For the subscribe button, dot subscribe, you have to specify like, hey, this receives a string as a parameter, right? You can send parameters with this. So this is the object that I'm subscribing this, which is the main page in this case. I'm sending this test message, right? That's the message that knows like, hey, I'm subscribed to this message, or, oh, I can ignore this one. So whenever we send something, it's going to check like, oh, is this the message that I'm actually subscribed to? Yes, then I'm going to trigger my logic. And then here is the method that it's actually going to invoke, right? So we get this string parameter, which is a message, and then we're going to display the alert with that and do that, right? And send then actually sends messaging center.send. It has a string parameter, and then this is the string parameter, and this is the message that we're sending through our pub/sub mechanism, right? And then unsubscribe, for you need to make sure that you have the same signature, right? That this is a string parameter right here, so it unsubscribes from the right thing. What is the object that we want to unsubscribe? It's this. And then what is the message that we want to unsubscribe from, right? Okay, perfect. So we got that. Now, this project runs on .NET 9. So if I go into the CGS prod right here, if I just update this to .NET 10, now, little disclaimer for myself, if you update to .NET 10, right, it's going to install some new things. So it might have some clear, I have to clear some caching. I might have to even restart Visual Studio because this is a bigger change, right? It needs to clear out some things, but you know, I'm doing this for you anyway, so you can see. And it starts restoring the packages and everything. Or of course, I already have .NET 10 preview at the time of recording already installed. And if I go back now here, it starts, you know, doing all these things, and you can see Messaging Center, hey, is inaccessible due to its protection level, because we didn't really actually remove it yet. We were planning to do that for .NET 10 GA, but at this time we just made it internal because we have some places in our code base, our own code base, where we're still using it. So it's internal, but you cannot use it anymore so that you can transition off it. So, okay, not cool, but my plugin to the rescue. So let's install that. Let's go to the Solution Explorer, right click, manage NuGet packages. And what I can then do is then browse and do plugin.Maui.MessagingCenter. That's what it's called, right? So we're just gonna look that up. Here it is. And already 12.4K downloads, right? So a lot of people are actually looking into this already. Download that, apply it, and you can see that it has a dependency on CommunityToolkit.Mvvm 8.4.0, right? So that might not be the latest one, I'm actually not sure. But that is what it's using under the hood. So it's open source, the plugin. You can look at the repo. I'll link it down in the video description. But it should be good to go, right? So we have that. And then the only thing that you kind of like need to do is say here, using plugin.Maui.MessagingCenter. There we go. And boom, it knows the messaging center again, because I just adopted that name. I adopted this message method signature, right? Subscribe with a string parameter, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. It all just works again, right? So it just now uses this thing. Just by adding using plugin Maui Messaging Center, I didn't need to change any code. I just, you know, it just works. Perfect. The one thing that you will see here is because of .NET 10, we've also deprecated display alert. I don't run around in panic, only because we wanted to change the name to make it more aligned with other methods that we have in here. So change that to display alert async, and we're all good to go again. Now, let's see if I can actually run this. Like I said, it might, you know, it has to recompile. It goes to .NET 10. Deployment errors, yeah, I can see. So we need to kind of like do it again. Actually, let me just start a new Visual Studio instance right here and open this one again. And then I'll close the other one here in the background. So you can see I'm not tricking you into anything, but now it should, you know, clear all the things, get the new .NET 10 bits in there, and I might speed it up a little bit so that it doesn't show you the full build, because I change a lot now, right? It doesn't seem like a lot. I just changed 9 to 10, but it still kind of like seems that I'm changing a lot, because this is like a whole new major version of .NET. So it has to rebuild some things. And then when it comes back up, you can see that it will just run the way it did before, but now using this new drop-in compatible plugin that I've created together with Copilot. And that was the cool, crazy thing about this little bit of backstory here. Like I just said, like, hey, I have this interface, because there's an interface above this. Let's see if I can dive into the definition of this messaging center right here. You can see that it has like an interface as well, which is also included, like, hey, iMessaging Center, which is the exact same that I took from the .NET Maui codebase. And then we also had like unit tests in the .NET Maui codebase. And I said, like, hey, I have this interface. That's what you should implement. I have these tests. Those should pass. And I want you to use the implementation of the Mvvm toolkit, right? And it went off. I had to give it a little bit of tips and hints here and there, but it figured it out mostly by itself, and it works and it passes all the tests. So that's really cool. Okay, so here we are again. Android, send message. Here we go, unsubscribe, and it all works. And it doesn't work anymore because unsubscribe. And now when I subscribe twice, you will see that it throws the exception, right? So that's the breaking change right here. So you can see it works as before without virtually changing any code. So that's really amazing if you ask me. This is what you should do if you don't have enough time to rewrite the whole thing to the Weak Reference Manager. Put in this plugin. I think the plugin will be like low maintenance, but I'm not planning on like maintaining it and doing a whole lot of work on it and adding all kinds of things to it. This is just a little helper to, you know, make your life a little bit easier to make that transition happen. But ideally, you want to transition to that Weak Reference Manager as soon as possible, but this should help you to get there. What else do you want to know about .NET 10? I'm planning on making a video on the new media picker functionalities. That's something that you'd want to see. Or just check out what is up and coming in .NET 10 for .NET Maui. Check out this video right here, and I'll see you for that one. Let me know in the comments what you'd like to see. See you for the other video.